Hello everyone, this is Akash here. Welcome to my channel. So in this video, I'm going to talk about how can you create a Jenkins job using parameters. There are multiple ways we can create jobs in Jenkins. We have list parameter, we have string parameters, we have Boolean parameters. So we'll just learn that how we can create a job in Jenkins first, and then how we can use different parameters type over here. So the agenda for this video is how to create a Jenkins job, and then we'll be talking about how do we create a simple bash shell script and how we can run that script in a Jenkins job. Okay, and then we'll have how to create a Jenkins job using string parameters, and then we'll have the list parameters, and last but not the least, we'll learn how do we create a job using the Boolean parameters. So this is the agenda for this video. Now let's go to the terminal. So before starting this video, you will first have to install Docker in your machine, in your Linux machine or Windows machine. In this video, I'm going to use a Linux Ubuntu machine where I have installed Docker engine as well as Docker client. So if you don't know how to install Docker, maybe you can check my previous video where I have explained that how do you install Docker from scratch. Okay, so the moment you install Docker, you will be able to see your version over here. So the Docker version will show both client as well as server. Okay, and also in my previous video I have explained what is Jenkins and how do you install Jenkins using a Docker container. So I have already installed Jenkins over here, so just see the Docker container running for the Jenkins. Okay, so this is my container ID for the Jenkins installation. So let's go over here. Okay, so I'll just curl my IP, and this is my IP, and as you can see that the port 8080 exposed over here. So I'll just go to the, yeah, so it is already opened over here, but this is my IP and this is my port. So I'll just create a simple job. The name of the job is test demo and it is going to be a freestyle job. Okay. I'll just write a description as my first Jenkins job, first Jenkins demo job, and as part of the build step I'm going to use shell, because the container where I'm going to run has a bash shell. Okay, so over here I'll just write echo my name. Echo my name is Akash Kumar. Okay, so if you just try to build now, click on build now, and yeah, this is passed. If you go to the console log, it will show that whatever we have asked the shell, that you have to echo and my name. So it echoed, it printed my name is Akash Kumar. Okay, so now we'll just go back to the job again and we'll try some, we'll just play around with the job. So configure it again. So this time we are going to run with a predefined Linux command. So I'm just trying to print the current user which I have logged in with. So the current user I have logged in with is, so I'll just show in the container here. So first of all, you have to log into the container. So just do docker exec hyphen it, and then the container ID over here, and you need a shell. So in my case, I'll just use bash shell. Okay, so you are inside a container. So just say who am I, and it will print a username. So the username this container is using is Jenkins. So I'll just try to fetch it over here. So to fetch here, you just have to use dollar and then the parenthesis who am I, and the close the bracket. Okay, so and you have to add the double quote in both the side and then save. If you build it again, it should print the user. So yeah, it printed the current user I have logged in with is Jenkins. So that's how you can just play around with all the commands. Maybe you can just also print. And today's date and time is dollar parenthesis date. Okay. Just say build now. And yeah, you can see here the current user I have logged in with is Jenkins, and today's date and time is Friday, April, and then the time, the current time in UTC format. So that's how you can play around with the console. Now we'll just go to the container. Okay. And we'll try to create a sample shell script which we will be running through Jenkins. Okay. So just say vi, we are inside a container, so just say vi demo underscore scripts. So it failed. Okay, so you can see over here it failed that because vi command not found. So as you can see that this particular container doesn't have vi installed, the vim editor installed inside a container, because this container is meant to run only Jenkins and the predefined libraries and binaries of Jenkins. So if you would have seen my first video of Docker, I have explained that Docker container is used to run your application along with all the libraries and binaries which are required to run your application. Okay, so in this case, for this container, only the Jenkins libraries and binaries will be executed. So might be Jenkins doesn't require Vim editor to be installed as part of this container. So if you still want to explicitly install Vim editor or Git or curl, so maybe you can create a Docker file and you can just create a base image of Ubuntu and then you install Jenkins. After that, you can install other packages like Vim, Git, curl, etc. Okay. So now that we don't have vi over here, we'll just exit the container. And here I'll just inside my Linux environment, the Ubuntu environment, I'll be creating a demo script. So demo script.sh. Okay, so here I'll just first write hash. Okay, so this is the first line which we have to use inside the shell script. Okay, so this line basically gives you the interpreter. Okay, so it says that which particular shell I am using in my shell script. Okay, so there are several kind of shell available in a Linux environment. You have bourne shell, that is sh, you have con shell, you have bourne again shell. So like that we have several shells available. So in over here we are using bash shell, so that's the reason we have written like that. And it is available inside the bin folder, so bin have all the libraries and binaries. And then I'll just echo, it's a very small script, I'm just trying to echo my name is dollar name and I belong to dollar city. Okay, so this is my simple script which I am trying to run. Okay, so let's try to run this one, /demo script.sh. So this is the command to run. Okay, so it says permission denied. So you need a your user needs an executable permission to run a script. So since this script is just now created, we need to provide a permission to it. So to provide the permission, you have to use chmod +x is the executable permission for all kind of users in this particular machine. Okay, and then you have to provide the script name. So chmod +x and the script name will give you the executable permission to this particular script. Okay, so now if you run demo script.sh, it says my name is and I belong to it is still blank. So let's go and see the script. Okay, so Linux has a different way of providing parameters. So you have to give the numbers, to give the order of all the parameters which you want to provide. So Linux understand this numbering, that $1, $2, And then as part of $1, you can just provide name is equal to $1. Then city is equal to $2. So now if you go out, just to say demo script.sh, and you have to provide your name as Akash and the city I belong to is Bangalore. So now you can see that the script has printed the result as expected. My name is Akash and I belong to Bangalore. Okay. So now let's try to run this particular script using Jenkins. So how do I do that? So before running this, I have to first push this particular shell script inside my container, because this is available in my Linux environment, in my Ubuntu machine, and I'm not inside my container since VI editor is not available over there. So I'll just say docker cp, then my script name, and then you have to provide your container ID. So maybe you can just go to docker ps, and then you run docker cp, your script name, the container ID is this one, and after that you have to provide colon, and then you have to provide the folder, the directory which is inside the container. So the directory available inside the container is temp, so I'm going to place it inside a temp folder, and that same script and that same script name. Okay, so now it has been copied. So let's go and check docker exec. -it for the interactive terminal, container ID, and then bin bash. So I'm inside my container. So just let's do slash tmp demo. Okay, so my script is now available, and this is the place where my script can be executed. So this is the same job. I'll just edit the same job. Yeah. And then I'll just provide Akash, and then the second parameter as Bangalore. And just save this one. If you build it again, the build has been completed. Now you can see over here the script has been successfully passed. So let's go to the job again, and this time instead of using the parameters directly over placing over here, we will use the build with parameter feature of Jenkins. Okay, we will just go up and create this project is parameterized. We will just select this project is parameterized, go to add parameter, and here we'll just select string parameter. So this is our first parameter type which is being widely used. So the name of the parameter I'll use as name, and a default value is Akash. So this is my name string parameter. Okay, I'll add one more string parameter as city. Default value is Bangalore since I belong to Bangalore, and this is my city string parameter. Just save it. So now you can see over here, instead of build, now we can see it is coming as build with parameters, because we have set the build along with the parameter. Okay, so the default values are coming over here, that for the name parameter I have given the value is Akash, for the city I have given the value is Bangalore. So let's build it. So you can see here. Okay, so it is failing because we have not configured the script to have these parameters. So you have to provide over here name and then city. So same parameters you have to use which you have provided over here. So the name is name and the city is the second parameter. If you save now and build a parameter again. Just say build. Yeah, it is now successful. My name is Akash and I belong to Bangalore. So let's just try to change the values. So my name is Anil and I belong to Chennai. So like that you can change the parameters and you can have different result every time. So that's how you can play around with the build with parameter for the string parameters. Now we are going to change instead of string parameters for city, we are going to use we are just closing this one. So now we are going to use the second parameter as choice parameter. So earlier the name of the in the previous Jenkins the name of this parameter was list parameter, so don't get confused with this. So maybe we'll just use the same name as city and we'll be having different choices. For example, the first choice is Bangalore, then Chennai, Delhi and Goa, and this is my choice city parameters. Just save this one and this time if you just try to build with parameter, so the first string parameter comes as it is, you just have to provide one value over here, and as part of city now you have different values over here. So that's how you can get the list. So you have four values, whatever value you provide inside the job configuration, all the values will come over here and you can choose one of that. So if I choose Delhi and run, as part of the result you can see that my name is Akash and I belong to Delhi. So that's how you can play around with string and the list parameter or the choice parameter. So now I'm going to use one more parameter, that is Boolean parameter. So these three parameters are being very widely used in any organization wherever you are using Jenkins. So there are several other parameters, I'm not going to cover this one. Maybe you can just try it out yourself or you can just place a comment in this video if you have any doubt using these parameters. Okay, so before making this change, so before using the Boolean parameter, I'm going to make some change in my shell script. So let's go back to the terminal. So yeah, so just open demo script.sh. So now that we have this one, we are going to have one more parameter, that is values to be printed equal to $3, that is my third parameter. I'm going to give a condition over here, if. So that's how you use if condition in the shell script. If the values, I'm just going to paste the parameter name. So if the values to be printed is equal to true, else echo please select the values to be printed option. Okay, so in this case I'm going to use this particular script in the Jenkins. So in the shell script you might not be able to check the functionality, because you have to provide the values true or false, then only you'll be able to see the functionality. But we will show you how we can use this particular Boolean function, Boolean parameter, in the Jenkins job. We just have to end it with F5 to close the if statement. So now that we have done the local changes inside my script, we have to copy this particular script inside my container. So just say docker-cp demo script and then the container ID. So maybe you can just see the container ID as docker-ps. After that colon, then slash temp. Inside that, I'll just use this particular script name again. So that's the same script. Let's go and check inside the container docker-exe. exec-it for the interactive terminal, and then the container ID bash bin bash So just say cat slash dmp demo. So yeah, you can see over here the script has the change. So we'll just go back. Let's click on configure again. I'm going to use the same job. So we are going to add one more parameter, that is the boolean parameter. So we'll just name it as value to be printed. You can use any one, you can use any parameters over here. So default value is true, and this is my boolean parameter. So I'm going to place the third parameter variable over here, that is value to be printed. Just save this one. So now that we have changed the job configuration with the boolean parameter, just say build with parameter. So by default, the first parameter is string parameter, and I will just use the default value Akash. The city I'm going to change it as Delhi, and the boolean parameter which returns true or false. I'll first start with false, as it returns, if you don't select anything, it returns false. Yeah, so it says the condition as false Akash Delhi, and the third condition is false. So it returns please select the value to be printed option, because I have selected a checkbox as false. So it returns the second condition, the else condition. Now let's run with the true parameter. So by default it selects the true parameter. So the same name Delhi and the parameter as true, boolean parameter as true. So let's go and check the result. So the my name is Akash and I belong to Delhi, because it selects the true for the boolean parameter. So that's how you can play around with the parameters in Jenkins job. So these are the three types of parameter which you are gonna use the maximum in Jenkins. So that's all for this video. Thanks a lot for watching. Please like, share and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.